Nestled at the northern tip of New Zealand's South Island lies New Zealand's smallest national park, where lush native forests meet golden sandy beaches, where glacier rivers meet tropical seas. The Abel Tasman National Park is filled with pristine coastal scenery, and despite its small size, it's one of the most visited places in the country. At the heart of the park lies the renowned Abel Tasman Coastal Track. Spanning 60 kilometers of well-maintained trails, this iconic trek weaves through some of the most beautiful coastal scenery New Zealand has to offer. The track has numerous coves and inlets to explore, making it a must-do for hikers and kayakers alike. Starting from the southern end in Marahau, we're planning 3 nights in the national park. Our first being 15 kilometers to the infamous Anchorage Bay, and continuing another 3 kilometers to camp at the secluded and picturesque Te Pokitea Bay. The weather during our trip is looking a bit finicky in parts, but that won't deter us. This trip is particularly special to us as we're being joined by Danny's best friend, Sarah, visiting all the way from Western Australia. We've been looking forward to tackling this one for a while. This is episode 7 of our Great Walk series, the Abel Tasman Coastal Track.
Thank you.
only supposed to rain 3 mils today, but it's just been like nonstop. Just a little bit of drizzling all day. It's annoying. Makes swimming difficult. That view is just absolutely stunning. Sarah and Daniel left because I was taking too long. but how could you not? It's so good. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to day two on the track. We've awoken to sunshine, which is nice. Nice change from yesterday. Very welcome. We've gone about 13 to 14 kilometers to Ontahati campsite. Ontahati? Wantahati? Wantahuti? Onatahuti? Onatahati? However you pronounce it.
Wantahuti.
Should be a pretty cruisy day. Just heading back towards Anchorage Hut and then across Torrent Bay at low tide. So far, this trail is absolutely stunning. And today should be the same. Let's do it. Good morning, guys. Welcome to day three on the track. Had a bit of an early start this morning because we realized we had 19 kilometers to Mutton Cove. And also, the forecast says rain. Hasn't come yet, but knock on wood, it doesn't come. Try to get an early start as we're going to Hourwater Lodge this morning for potentially some sort of caffeinated beverage, maybe a pastry. Who knows? The girls' expectations are low, my expectations are high, so we'll see who's either disappointed or pleasantly surprised. Regardless, we're just gonna hang out at the lodge for a little bit, wait for the tide to come down, because we have to cross the estuary this morning. Rain or no rain, should hopefully be a good day. I'm so excited, guys.
Managing expectations.
Anyone smell bacon? Mission was a critical success, but just started raining right when we're about to leave. Play chess? Your move! Except black one first. A lot. pretty much the worst timing. We're gonna be out in the open for the next 40 minutes, half an hour, or 40 minutes, an hour. Grouse, it's like quicksand. Oh no, which way did I go? Well, that was quite the experience, but we've made it across. We've got 6Ks, about 2 hours to Totonuri, where we have to make a decision on what we're gonna do for tomorrow. But we'll talk about that later. The one good thing about the rain in New Zealand is that it makes the forest so vibrant. And all the colors just popping. something on. And with the magic of video editing, we are back on the track. I'd like to apologize for that interruption. We had to leave the track because a pretty big storm was coming in, and we didn't really want to expose Sarah to an uncomfortable night in the tent and then a potentially uncomfortable day the next day, especially while she's on vacation visiting us. So we decided to take a water taxi from Toe Ternary back to Mauhau and call it quits there. And now Danny and I are back on a beautiful sunny day, like nothing ever happened. We are about 1 kilometer away from Toe Ternary. We parked our car at Wainui Bay, hiked up and over the Gibbs Hill track, and now we are on our way towards Mutton Cove. Gibbs Hill track was all right. It was a lot more in the shade than I thought it was gonna be. Had some decent views from the top, but yeah, nothing special. More of just a link track. We've only got about 5 kilometers to Mutton Cove campground, which is where we were originally supposed to spend the night with Sarah, and the weather is a lot better. So I'm looking forward to it. Should be a good little walk. Let's do it. Let's finish off this track. Abel Tasman part 2. One last thing. Sarah, if you're watching this, we're really upset that you're not here to finish this with us, but the show must go on. Mutton Cove. The weather's changing. It's definitely getting a lot cloudier. Looks like the sun's gonna go down pretty soon. We're just gonna chill out, have a cup of tea, maybe have a beer. We'll go check out Separation Point tomorrow morning where there's supposed to be a seal colony. And then head to Wainui Bay, finish off the track. I think we've snagged the best campsite in the area. I think Anapawa Bay was probably a bit nicer, but this is a nice grassy area. It's just the beach is a bit more exposed, it seems like. But either way, both good campsites. I'll see you guys in the morning. Bye. Good morning and welcome to the final day on the track. It rained all night last night, so everything was very wet. But we have woken to an absolutely beautiful day. Couldn't ask for anything better to finish it off. Just leaving Mutton Cove. It's only about 10 kilometers to Wainui Bay, but we're gonna make a quick stop at Separation Point first and hopefully see some seals, because it's supposed to be a seal colony out there. We go past the final hut on the track. Can't remember the name of it, and I probably wouldn't be able to pronounce it anyways, but I think it's supposed to be like one of the coolest huts in New Zealand, one of the most unique. So looking forward to checking that out. Should be a very cruisy day. This is the final day on the Abel Tasman Coastal Track. Let's check it out. That was pretty cool. Definitely worth the detour and spending a bit of time down there. Next stop, Farafarangi Hut, if that's how you pronounce it. That was an interesting hut. Probably wouldn't say it's the coolest one, but it's definitely more unique. Really old wood. It's got an upstairs with two bunk rooms, actual chimney, and apparently it's haunted. The grass area around the hut is very, very nice though, so even just camping there would be really cool. We are leaving the coast behind and now heading inland to Wainui Bay. just want to thank you again for clicking on this video and supporting us. It really does mean a lot. Enjoy these last shots while we head up to Winery Bay. We'll catch you in the next one.
Look at me.